Hey everyone, this is Aagam Singh Sisodiya and you're watching Disease Media. Today, we are going to talk about a very, very important topic, that is arrhythmia. If you or anyone in your circle is suffering from chest pain, fluttering in the chest, fainting or dizziness, then it may be arrhythmia, which is not a normal situation. And it is also a bitter truth that if you left arrhythmia untreated, then it may cause life-threatening complications such as stroke, heart failure, or sudden cardiac arrest. So now let's understand arrhythmia and find out that how we can treat this problem. And up to the end of the video, you will learn a technique that how you can check at home that your heart is okay. In general, our heart beats 60 to 100 times per minute. But in arrhythmia, due to improper working of sinus or SA node, the improper electrical impulse generates, which leads to abnormal beating of heart, whether irregular, too fast, or too slow. When the heart beats too slow, which is less than 60 beats per minute, the condition is known as bradycardia. While when the heart beats too fast, which is more than 100 beats per minute, the condition is known as tachycardia. And when there is irregular heartbeat rhythm, the condition is known as fibrillation. So now you had understood that what is arrhythmia and how it happens, but still you are not familiar with the causative factors of arrhythmia. So let's know about them. Arrhythmia can be caused due to coronary artery disease, high blood pressure, change in heart muscles due to cardiomyopathy, valve disorder, electrolyte balance in blood such as sodium or potassium, injury from heart attack, the healing process after heart surgery, and other medical conditions. Okay, let's know about the treatment of arrhythmia. In some cases, it is seen that arrhythmia goes off its own when the person stops the use of alcohol or other drugs and maintain a good electrolyte balance. While in most of the cases, medical treatment requires that varies from person to person, which basically includes medications such as antiarrhythmics, which helps controlling abnormal or irregular heart rhythm, calcium channel blockers, which relax blood vessels, beta blockers, which slow down heart rate and decrease blood pressure. But before using them, please consult your doctor. While in severe cases, implantable devices such as pacemakers are implanted through surgery. Now this is the time of some frequent questions which are asked by lots of people. Question number one, that how you can treat arrhythmia naturally. As like lots of causative factors of arrhythmia, one more cause is stress, which causes arrhythmia. So for relieving the stress, we can take vitamin E and vitamin C rich fruits and vegetables, which are biologically tested for relieving the stress. Next question, which food to avoid if you have arrhythmia? Foods which contain alcohol, caffeine, fat, salt, vitamin K, gluten should to be avoided. Next, is exercise good for heart arrhythmia? Yes, it benefits overall cardiovascular health. Now the final and the most important question, that how you can check at home that your heart is okay. For that, you have to take your index finger and middle finger and place it on the base of your thumb. Not on the wrist, you just have to place it on the base of the thumb and have to find out the pulse, okay? And when you got the pulse, then you have to start a stopwatch up to 10 seconds. And you have to count how much beats, how much pulses you get in 10 seconds. Okay, when you get the amount of pulses, for example, you get 12 pulses in 10 seconds. Okay, then you have to multiply 12 with 6, and whatever the pulse you get in 10 seconds, you have to multiply with 6 so that you can get the amount of pulses in 1 minute, because you know that 1 minute contains 60 seconds. So the amount of pulses in 60 seconds you get after multiplying this. If the pulse count is between 60 to 100, then your heart is okay. But if the pulse is going down the 60 or above the 100, then it is not a normal situation with you. Please consult a doctor, because it can lead to severe situations such as stroke or sudden cardiac arrest. And it is also right that person doesn't experience the symptoms when the heartbeat is going between 50 to 60. But when the heartbeat goes down to 50, then the person start to have the symptoms. And sometimes the heartbeat goes so much slow that it becomes the sudden cardiac arrest. So that's all about arrhythmia. I hope you will take it seriously. If you like this video, then give it a thumbs up. Please share this video with your family and friends, because this will create awareness in people about their life. And if you haven't subscribed this channel, then subscribe this channel. Press the bell icon and select all to get more notifications about these type of videos. You can also follow me on my social media. I have my Twitter, I have my Facebook, I have my Instagram, and I have my Hindi YouTube channel, Biology with Aagam Singh. So that's all for today. I will see you later in the next video.